Hello, everyone. I am honored to introduce our final Free Expression Award winner of the night, the Global Freedom of Expression Leadership Award, which goes to General Colin Powell. General Powell is a soldier who has served our nation from Vietnam to the Gulf War and a statesman in peacetime. He was Ronald Reagan's national security advisor, George Herbert Walker Bush's chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and George W. Bush's secretary of state. He led men and women who fought and died to protect the freedoms represented by the American flag. And he also publicly and powerfully supported the right of those who chose to protest against it. General Powell has been fearless in combat and courageous in peacetime in speaking truth to power when the President of the United States criticized the press as enemies of the people. General Powell said, no, you're not supposed to like everything the press says or what anyone says. That's why we have a First Amendment, to protect that kind of speech. General Powell is known for his integrity, his dedication to public service, and his devotion to the Constitution that preserves and protects the freedoms that we all hold dear. So let's take a look at the inspirational career and life of General Colin Powell.
The First Amendment right of free speech is intended to protect the controversial and even the outrageous word, and not just comforting platitudes too mundane to need protection. But for this freedom to hear all views, you bear a burden to sort out wisdom from foolishness.
You're not supposed to like everything the press says or what anyone says in the First Amendment. That's why we have a First Amendment, to protect that kind of speech.
I'd like to read something that General Powell said about this amendment. I would not amend that great shield of democracy to hammer a few miscreants. The flag will be flying proudly long after they have slunk away.
I once interviewed him and said, General Powell, here you are, son of Jamaican immigrants, born in Harlem, raised in the South Bronx. You're black and you're chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. He said, it's a wonderful country, Sam, it's a wonderful country.
This is the country I love, I will argue. I will debate anyone who wants to debate. What we have to do is not simply scream at everybody. Let's have a conversation.
And I would say of General Powell what Harry Truman said of General Marshall. He is a tower of strength and common sense. When you find somebody like that, you have to hang on to him.
I found something that I did well and something that I loved doing. And when you find those two things together, man, you got it.
It is a personal privilege and honor for me. I consider General Powell a friend. General Colin Powell, please accept this Global Freedom of Expression Leadership Award for your lifetime of representing and defending our First Amendment freedoms.
Good evening, everyone. It's a great pleasure for me to be with you this evening as you pay tribute to all of these wonderful people who have been involved in the work of your group and who also represent the kind of fantastic things that we have to say about what we are doing with respect to freedom of the speech. But I have a deep sense of feeling for this organization. But more importantly, I have a deep sense of feeling for what you stand for. I have been an American in public life for going on 50 years. The first 25 of them, 35 of them were to be a soldier. And as a soldier, I had responsibilities. And one of the responsibilities I had was to defend the Constitution of the United States, to defend the United States of America. And one of the things that was so precious to me is that in serving the United States of America and defending the United States of America, one of the things I have to defend is not just fighting an enemy, but dealing with another enemy that could come about. And that is somebody trying to shut down the freedom of speech. And that's why I believe that the First Amendment, the first element of the Bill of Rights, I think is one of the most important elements of our Constitution, and especially of all of the amendments to the Constitution. How can I say that? What do I mean? What I mean is that I was fighting for freedom of speech. I was serving my country for freedom of religion. I was doing everything I could to protect my country in every single way with respect to what we stand for, and not just battles or armies, but things, visions, what we are doing here tonight. I remember so much that in the military, I would occasionally get into these little fights with some members of the media. It was something I had to stand for. And what I would say is, look, I like working with the media. I trust the media. I hope the media trust me. But you have to understand this. The media, I will help in every single way to give them all the information I have and they need to go on the air, with one exception. I also have to protect the soldiers of the United States of America. So there's always a little bit of a conflict and how close we can come between these two objectives. My responsibility as a soldier, as a citizen, I think, is to tell the public, tell my fellow citizens all I can, as long as I'm not putting their lives at risk. Because all of the people that I worked with in the Army were serving, putting their lives at risk. But I had to defend the rights that they have, the rights to come home safely, the rights to always believe and get ready to fight for freedom of the press, freedom of religion, and all the other freedoms that line up in your wonderful organization and in our wonderful country. And so I want to thank all of you for coming together tonight and to give awards to these individuals. I am especially honored and pleased that you would see me fit to give an award of this kind. But I want to tell you, and I can promise you this, I have gone through this many, many times where people have said, tell us more. Nope, I will tell you what I can tell you, but I will not give away any things that you should not have. And so I've tried hard to always, always be honest with the public, to be honest with the press. Press is the public is the press. And that's what we're all about. I cannot imagine an America that does not believe in these values. I cannot imagine that I fought for an America that did not realize what freedom of speech, freedom of religion, and all the other freedoms are about. That's the America I fought for. That's the America I believe in. That's the America so many Americans believe in. And we have to stand up against those Americans who see fit not to support us. This is what we do for a living. This is what I'm prepared to give my life for. My rights to speak out, your rights to speak out. This is what the foundation's all about. This is what you guys are all about. This is what makes your organization so impressive and so important to the nation. And I hope that you will appreciate that. And I also want to thank you once again for what you have done to honor those of us who have received the honor. I am honored because I'm not sure I really deserve it compared to those members of the press, members of the media, who have also put themselves in danger without being able to defend themselves. But they defended the country. They defended the country they believe in, a country that we could not be the country we are if it wasn't for those of you who cover the press, cover the media, tell us the truth, and fight against those who will not tell us the truth. I've always tried to tell the truth. I've always tried to do it. I've gotten in trouble a few times in the military or in even civilian life when I pushed back and said, no, won't do it, can't do it. Why can't you do it? Because I'm violating the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. But more importantly, I'm violating the people of the United States who are expecting me to do it the way I have said I will do it, the way I have been told to do it by the Constitution, and the way I have been told to do it by every one of my fellow citizens. And when I see something wrong, I will speak out about it. I've done that a number of times, had to do it with the flag several times. Honor the flag, honor what it stands for, but don't want to burn it. But if you do want to burn it, you have the freedom to do that. It is a piece of cloth that has been purchased by a civilian, and that piece of cloth is owned by that civilian to do what that civilian wants to do. I hope he won't do it, but he has the right to do it and the freedom to do it. And because he has the right and he has that freedom, I have protected my rights and my freedoms. It's a great pleasure to be with you tonight, to share this evening with all those who are being given honors, and to give my best wishes to the Freedom Forum. You guys are making the difference. Thank you.
Friends, thank you so much for being with us tonight. We look forward to seeing you next year at the Anthem.